Prayers answered immediately. Okay, this is the sixth and final teaching that I'm going to give. The seventh video, it's all going to be question and answer from you guys, your great questions. And you may have noticed that it's sort of backloaded, meaning in this last one, we're covering the helmet, the sword, and praying in the spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the saints. All that is ready. it's just ready to go into the day. But people say, is that a piece of armor? I think it's in some ways the biggest, because you're just saying, I'm going to stay attuned to you all day long. So in this, when I pray, I said this earlier, and I want to say it again. Now you're on the helmet. I would estimate over 90% of all Christians regularly wonder if they're going to heaven. And it is so painful, because if your head is such a vital place, I mean, you think about the vital places as organs, it's the breastplate and the head. Those are the two things where with a sword stroke, you can be killed instantly. And so the ability of the enemy to attack you, scripture says, let me give you some key scriptures. Romans 8:16, the spirit himself testifies with our spirit that we are God's children. Now, the thing that's cool about that is you've already prayed Romans 8:15, the spirit of sonship crying, Abba, Father. So when you put this on, think about this. You have such a cleanness because you have set the highest level of humility. I'm going to be a lover of the heart of Jesus. I'm going to hear people. If I hear your heart. And you've gone through and got all the multitude of counselors ordered in your life. Then you've got the pleasure of God on you, in you, and through you. And you're free from trying to please or criticize or be criticized. But you're searching for hungry souls and good soil to pour affirmation and encouragement. Then your schedule is just like so killer, cool, and calm, and wise, and peaceful, and the Spirit of God's just chatted with you. Each point, your faith is going up and up and up. And that's why the fourth one, you've taken up the shield, and now you're just declaring faith. And how sweet God is to us, that we've declared all these things of faith. He said, now declare the greatest thing of faith. And that is, you are mine. You see, when it says the Spirit himself testifies with our spirit, God is literally saying, you're mine. You're mine. You are my child. 1 John 5:13, John said, I write these things to you who believe in the name of the Son of God that you may know that you have eternal life. If ever that verse applied, it's right now. You know you believe. You know that you're doing this. So this is just sort of a repetitive thing but what happens is, each time you put this helmet on, there's something fierce in you that says, I know I'm going to heaven. I belong to God. I claim heaven is my home. And then you go on from there. And the last three pieces total take me usually less than a minute. So this is just, I claim eternal life. I take up the sword of the Spirit, which is the rhema of God. I claim that I will hear God's voice today. And I go forth, lead me, trust you, lead me. Because those who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God, which is Romans 8:14. We hit 14, 15, and 16. So it's just bam, 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 Cunningham. And so we got, again, God, y'all laugh at anything. I like this crowd. So it's gotten easier and easier and easier. You just soar. But before we pray, I have a very tender, gentle appeal. And I ask you to hear this in the right heart and not let it distract you. I'm going to say something very important. The armor of God is the second most powerful prayer tool you'll ever have. It is not a tenth as powerful as quoting chapters of the Word. And so what I would beg you is, if you're feeling excited about the armor of God and eager and itching, don't worry about what this right now. If you'll just pray the armor for 2, 3, 4, 5 years, but I'm putting a little seed in your heart that there's going to come a day that you want more power. And I could say this a million times. I could cling to your ankles and weep over your feet and say, please, hunger-based memorizing, hunger. I'm right now finishing up 2 Timothy chapter 4, and it's like, wow, it's only August, and I really was supposed to take the whole year, and I've only got 3 verses left after this, and they're short verses, and so, and I'm looking ahead, and I've just finished 4:18, I peaked today at 4:19, And I cheated by looking, you know, and I said, okay, John, you may not start, and I want to start it today, 419. You may not start it till September 15th. And I said, that's like 2.5 weeks from now. And I have never once, since I started this 1981, ever made myself go on to the next verse. I've never gone on to the next verse. Every single verse I've ever gone on, I took when I wanted to do it, made myself wait at least half a week or a week. So it's like, finally I get to memorize another verse. And so 42 chapters, I lose count. 42 chapters that I quote every week. I quote when I'm stretching. I quote when I'm driving. I quote a chapter in between each piece of armor. I can go on 4-hour times of prayer and a 4-hour drive and pray the whole time and free float in the Lord. I can take any thought and just make it completely lined up and take it captive in the presence of God. So if you would hear my appeal, don't let this distract you from getting started on the armor. But ask God that one day you would come back and that God will give you a hunger-based memorizing, that 30 years from that day you have 30 chapters of the Word. So let's wrap this up. We're going to pray the last three pieces of armor. You guys have been so wonderful. We'll have a question-answer time in just a minute. But let's close our eyes and pray. And if you place yourself in a memory place, you just finished proclaiming faith, I trust you. I trust you to bless. I receive your favor. I release your blessing, all these things. And that's why, to me, I go right in that faith-charged moment. I go in and I say these words, say this, and say, by the finished work of Jesus Christ,
by the finished work of Jesus Christ,
by the promises of God's word. And at this point, if you had some scriptures that you wanted to quote, I don't need to anymore, but there were times I would quote 1 John 5:13 and Romans 8:16. But you're just saying, by the promise of God, after you say by the promise of God word, say this. Say, I receive
a confidence
knowing that I'm going to heaven.
I receive the helmet of salvation.
Satan cannot take it from me.
It
is mine.
My God has claimed me.
And now with a heart full of faith,
I drink of the spirit of prophecy.
I take up the sword of the spirit. I always make the sound,
which is the word of God,
the voice of God.
I trust you today, Holy Spirit,
that I will hear your voice.
And I usually just listen at this point. If there's a picture, a thought, an impression, something I miss, a thought of my life, I'll just listen. Sometimes I get nothing. Sometimes I get a thought or a picture that comes to me.
And let's do the last one. Say, and now, Holy Spirit,
seal all of this armor.
Launch me into my day.
That whether it's a quick 2-second prayer
or praying on the armor again,
I'm ready
for wherever you want to lead me.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Give yourselves a hand. Y'all, that's so good. Oh, I love you guys.